So you've got Elyria taking on Lake Catholic coming up here. Should be a good one. Yeah, Lake Catholic had a competitive duel with Hoffman, so this should be a good one. Starting out with your number one 120 pounder in Division Two, Brendan McCrone from Lake Catholic. Should be a good one. Here we go. Match is brought to you by Defense Soap. Defense Soap, defend what you built. Barbie and Apparel, conquer the impossible. McCrone, your number one guy, Division Two, Ohio, at 120 pounds. He's out of the gate quick here. This is Elyria, Brendan McCrone from Lake Catholic. Looking for a fall, and there it is. McCrone doing McCrone things. He puts Lake Catholic up quick, fast, and in a hurry in this duel. You can see why he's the number one guy in Division Two in Ohio. McCrone and Lake Catholic out to a 6-0 lead here. On the mat.
Thank you. Get off your knees.
Yeah.
2020 Elyria Holiday Duels here at Elyria High School. Back. one time last year. First, 152 for the Sun. I'm putting a G in a three. Looking for it. All he's got to do is stop him. Could see a fall here. It'd be crazy. He's in a really bad spot. 46 seconds left. 15-12 Elyria. Score on the spot here at 152. Tripisano with that first attack. 15. Blood time right now at 152.
Yeah!
Pounds, folks, don't go anywhere. Evans and Hibner should be a good one. Mugia cranking power half on Boley. Mugia working hard here. Looking ahead, Scoop. Match is brought to you by Defense Hope, Defense Hope Belt. Mugia now has a double arm bar laced up. He's about to lock his hands. Oh, oh my goodness. 22 seconds to turn this over. Boley is up. And he's taking big steps with Mungia. Mungia hops sides. Mungia looking for it here. Referee looking concerned. And he is taking big steps. Mungia has got his hips into this. 5 seconds, he's not gonna get the turn. Mariko Mungia is going to have a dominant first period, 4-0. This duel is tied at 15, folks. So great duel, tied at 15 between Lake Catholic and Elyria. Mariko Mungia on the mat for the Pioneers, taking up Boley. Boley lost a tough overtime bout earlier today against Kaufman. Good and rolling. Mugia up and out. 5-0 lead, Rika Mugia. Elyria here. Sean Boley, a big Catholic. This is brought to you by Defense Soap and Barbarian Apparel Concept Impossible. Mugia takes a shot, crunches him. He stopped wrestling, hurt his back. And we are going to go to injury time. 15-15 on the board, 7-0 on the match. Up 7-0 here. Kent State commit. Dominating Boley. Does not look like Boley. He will continue. That's good. Mugia, driver's seat 7-0 lead, 1:22 remains in the second, Boley up to his feet. Mugia boot one side, then the other. Now he's looking to strap a cradle on, like a fall away cradle, like as he's falling off cradle. Putting the boots to him. You can hear Boley yelling out his crazy power at 51 seconds remains in the group. Mugia, a hammer on the mat, mean, wrestles in all positions really hard. Not a ton of offensive attacks to speak of, but he's working on it. McCrone had a quick fall to start this bout. So McCrone already picked up a fall to lead off, and there it is. Mugia is going to pin Boley. And Enrique Mugia, folks, look out. Golden Flash has got a good one. And he's showing you why he's one of the best guys in Ohio at 160 pounds. Mugia picks up the fall for Elyria. They now have a 21-15 lead. Offside. Yeah.
out, and they're going to bump Ebner up. Evans is a quick barrel roll. He's headed to Indiana, folks. He could be looking for a quick fall. This duel is tied at 21. Jake Evans is going to pick up the quick fall. Elyria now winning 27-21 against Lake Catholic. Evans with the fall. Headed to Indiana. So Hibner bumps up to 195. He is going to try and outdo Jake Evans. It's a quick takedown, looking for a fall. Pull him in. Bump him up to 95. He looked good earlier today. It's Broski. No. Evans. Match. Front headlock now. Cross ankle pick, looking for a fall is Cole Hibner. Trying to even this dual score up. They're getting some fight. Head up. 195 for Elyria. And Hibner, and there's a fall for Hibner and a quick fall for Hibner. And we got a 27-27 duel, folks. Barn burner Hibner with the win.
Yeah!
desperately needs a win here against Lake Catholic. They pick up a win here. We still have a chance to win the duel. Lake Catholic wins here. There's only two weights left after this. As the duel started at 120, there will be 6 and 13. So right now, it is 33-27 in favor of the Cougars of Lake Catholic. Second period. Pressure punt.
Come on, Ryan, you got this.
Let's go.
Sure. she can hang on here and not give up a fall, it would be huge going into the next match. What will happen is, she's down 9-1 right now. She can hang on and give up a major or a tap, but not a pin. Elyria can win with a fall. So, crazy stuff. Now 11-2. This could still be the hero of the day. Just battling. Oh, right into it. Breaker, nice go behind. Off the mat, no score. Wow. Now 58 seconds left. Getting to a defendable position. There's another takedown. 19-4 technical fall. 19-5. Oh, he needs another takedown. Bañez can just hang out, get out of bounds. 4 seconds. This would be huge. And she's not going to give up the tech fall and gives up a major. And that can win it for Elyria, depending on the outcome of this next bout. We shall see. Fall or major decision to get his team the win here against Romano. Noel versus Romano. Bañez gives up a major decision, not a tech fall at the end, loses 19-5, and puts her team in a position to win this duel against Lake Catholic.
So Knowles heading out. Knowles in a position to win the duel for Elyria. I just like Catholic, 37-33 right now. This is 113 pounds. Needs a tacker pin and it'll win it for Elyria. Off the mat, we're gonna get Noel Romano. Noel's gonna let him go. So any type of win, if Noel can pick up a major, it'll send it to Criteria. And he throws the deuce back. Elyria could be looking for a fall here. And that was beautiful. Nice little pancake by Colin Knoll. Oh, that was nice. And 37-33. Romano has to go out and try and preserve the win and the lead for Lake Catholic. Knoll, 6-1 lead. It looks like he can get to the threshold of at least a major. Romano tries to roll through. And Noel cranking power half. And Romano gonna battle and not give up any near falls. So here we go. Second period, 113. Colin Noel. Troy Romano. Choice Romano the first. Noel's choice gonna be neutral. Can be the hero today. Shot. Sits the corner, goes Noel. Grabs his own shin. He's going to end up in what looks like a crack guide type position. And makes it 8-1, Noel. He's going to be close to getting the major. He's got a 7-point lead. He needs 8. So it'll tie this bout up. Colin Noel can pick up a major decision. It's 37-33 up there right now. Strapped up here on Romano, could have him in some trouble. Can't quite get his fingertips locked. He's still on that corner, sitting at 8-1 lead. Elyria needs a tacker, a pin for the win, the outright win. Your coach Eric Burnett, you do not want this going to a. There's some near fall swipes, which is going to put him to the threshold of a major. Eric Burnett or Scott Hibbert, neither one of you wants this going to Criteria. There's the three near fall. 11-1, Colin Noel. The tackle do it too, and he's on his way to it. He's going to get the full allotment. No, he's not. And now he punches through looking for a fall. Be the hero of the day for Elyria. Colin Noel looking for it. Scott Romano in a bad spot. Straightens his arm out. Jumps sides, releases the legs. Great fight. Now he gets rolled over. He can get pinned. Goodness, Lake Catholic's in a position. Colin Knoll's got to get off his back. He gave up a 5-pointer. And Romano can pick up the ball. He looks pinned. Oh, my goodness. And now the major decision's negated. That makes it 11-6. 5-point move, huge. Knoll's got to get one. Romano, there's no quitting this guy. Wow, what a change of events. Yeah. 11-6 bout now. Woo. Pick up. Luckily that just happened at the break. Noel has a 14-6 lead. So he still has the major as Romano's underneath to start the third. I gotta look up and look. It's a 14-6. So he's got the major for the to go to Criteria, but if you're right now you're these guys, you're telling him you've got a tacker pin in, man. Yeah, those guys are saying you can't get Tucker pin. So 14-6 on the board. The criteria for the major decision is still there for me. We got it on the board. That'll just send this out to criteria. Just do it, because it'll be 37-37. And Noel can be the hero today. Got the boot in. Romano underneath for Lake Cap. Stretches him out. Can Noel pull a rabbit out of the hat, or will Romano hang on? Noel's got him flattened. Well, almost flattened out. Now he's flattened out. No quitting Romano. 14-6, major decision on the board right now, but an escape for Romano wins the duel outright for Lake Catholic. Noel's got to try and pin it. Stretching that arm out. Cranks that power half. Split out. Oh, this will negate the major. Romano's got a lot of fight in him. Noel with that closed wizard. If he can get a stalemate here, it'd be huge. His leg out. They're going to go one escape. 14-7. The major decision's been negated for Elyria to have a chance to take this to criteria. Noel needs a takedown and a ride out. There's a shot. Wait a minute. And Boot comes in. 16-7 for a 9-point lead. 25 seconds. Noel throws the boot. But what a third period and a second period, and that will make it 37-37 here. Noel picks up the win, 37-37, and Coach Gillespie already knows who won this. Did you win, Jack?
I don't know.
You don't know. Jack doesn't know. For the record, Jack doesn't know.
Head-to-head's even, falls are even.
Got it.
After that, I don't know.
Got it.
So we're down to criteria C, D, F, H.
Got it, yeah. So that's it. And I want to find out who won this thing before I shut it off. So 37-37 up on the board. Who won? Yeah, I don't know who won. Yeah, they've already gone past all that. It was all 7-7. It was equal. Now they've probably got to count near fall points. So we'll let you know as soon as we know.
Why don't you know the criteria?
37-37. Who's going to win? Is Elyria going to get the dub? We're finding out right now.